Good morning and welcome to the Saturday Morning Coffee Jams on signetradio.com. I'm Todd, I'm your host, and per usual, we're going to be spinning a record from my personal collection. But today, I got a couple special guests in studio, and they are Mick and Longhair from MATREKIS. What's up, dudes?
What up? We are special, by the way.
You guys are way special. But first off, they're going to actually play a tune here in a little bit. But first off, we're going to play side one of Kit's Creatures of the Night.
Yeah.
And you're listening to the Saturday Morning Coffee Jams on signetradio.com.
Come on.
You're listening to the Saturday Morning Coffee Jams on signetradio.com. That was side one of Kiss Creatures of the Night. And as I said, as we started the show, I have some special guests in studio. I have Mick and Long Hair from the Mighty Matrekis. What's up, guys?
Yeah. Hey, Jammo, will you say that name for Mick again?
Matrekis.
Is that how you say that?
Yeah, I think this band.
And by special guest, is that like calling a special
short bus rider?
That's kind of what I was getting at.
Yeah, well, you know, I've known you guys a long time, so you guys are special to me. So, anyways, I think talking about your name, that is actually something. Anybody that know you guys or watch your band, everybody says it different. So, let's get it on the record right now. What is the name of your band?
Tell us, Mick.
Matrekis.
Matrekis.
Matrekises.
Matrekis.
Matrekis.
Matrekis. I've heard it every different way. So again, we do have Matrekis in studio. We have Mick and Long Hair. And in just a bit, they're going to play their new song, Brother. And great tune. If you guys, anybody out there has seen them recently, you've seen this song. It's a very cool song. It's a very special song to them. And they'll tell you about that too. But why don't we real quick go back to Matrekis and maybe Long Hair or Mick, whoever wants to do, just kind of give us the history of Matrekis and how long you guys been together and all that stuff.
You'll have to do this one, man. I can only go back a little while.
2009, I believe.
2009.
It was Halloween show in Northwood, Iowa. The band that we were all playing in didn't show up. So it came down to the four of us and decided, you know what, we pulled off a hell of a show, and Matrekis started right there. We're like, you know what, if the founder of this band can't show up, then we'll just be our own show.
It's worked out well. I think I met you guys in 2010. I was in another band that will go nameless.
Yes.
And going forward a little bit, Mick and I were in that band together later on. But we met at, I think it was 400 Bar opening for Broken Teeth. And you guys were on that bill as well. And I think we've been friends ever since. Was that October of 2010?
Ooh.
Something like that. It was late 2010. I know that because that was... you know, a few months after I joined that band, and I probably should have left then, but you know.
Well, you didn't wait too long, and then you were gone, so, and you left me in that band, so you left me to deal with the aftermath of all that. And the people out there who know both of us know who we're talking about.
Exactly.
So we'll just leave it there.
Good times. But Mick and I go back too, even before that band, we were jamming in a band together that didn't get out of the basement, but we had some good times jamming and playing a lot of tunes, which was a great time.
Literally did not get out of the basement.
Right, it was in the basement.
It was funny because I remember, we were playing and then that band kind of disbanded or whatever, and, you know, we're all still friends with everybody there. And I remember talking to the rest of the guys going, you see this? Todd's in another band. He's like playing out like every day. What's up? And we can't get out of the basement. And I left that band to join the band that we were talking about.
Yep.
Immediately, I think we were playing out and playing some good big places. So
absolutely. And here you guys are today. So Matrekis, just so you know, Matrekis is playing with my band, The Good Bars, in July, on July 10th. So make sure you come out to Maze Lax and see that. I think that's your Maze Lax debut. Am I correct?
Or have you been there? That's our first shot there. Yeah.
Nice.
That should be a hell of a good time.
It's a great venue to play, and I think you guys will have a great time there as well. So so the song you guys are going to play for us today, why don't you kind of give us? Obviously, it's very special to you guys, and why don't you kind of give me a background on where that song came from and why it turned into a song.
Back 7 years ago, I guess it was, when my son was in high school, his best friend had committed suicide, and being close to the family, his mom wanted him to speak at the funeral. So Justin wrote the poem or eulogy, whatever you'd like to call it, and it can reflect to so many different people that we talked to Justin and said, hey, you know what, let's make a song out of it. And it sat idle for a long time, just never had the right equipment and the guys to pull it off with. And I threw it by Mick, and I'm like, you know, this could really do some good here.
I think what it was around Thanksgiving, so I had some time off, and he called me and said, he told me the story and then sent me the eulogy, and he says, can you do anything with it? And I think immediately I came up with something and recorded it and sent it to them, and I said, well, what do you think of this? And they said, yeah. And it literally was within 24 hours, I had the music and almost all the lyrics there. And I think one of the things is everybody can identify with suicide and loss, so it really kind of gripped me, and that's why it kind of flowed so easy. And a lot of people have a lot of connection with that because almost everybody has lost or been touched by somebody taking their own life, you know.
Right. Now, were the eulogy and the lyrics, was it pretty similar, or did you have to kind of work that eulogy to put it into the song it is today?
At some point, when we work on a new record, we want to put the eulogy and the lyrics next to each other. Mm-hmm. Yeah, they're very, very similar. I had to move some things around to, you know, fit it into a musical context. But for the most part, it's very, very similar. I took almost all his words into that song and moved them around and just tried to make it really simple and to the point and get it there, and they're very, very close.
Very cool. Now again, that Longhair's son Justin is the one that that wrote that eulogy, and is he back yet? He was over in Japan, right?
Yeah, no, he's still floating in the oceans now. Okay. They should be back at the end of May.
Is he a Marine? Is that
yeah, with the Marines?
Marines, yep. So he'll be back. He'll be back soon, and hopefully he hasn't seen you guys play it live yet. So
no, he hasn't even seen the new lineup yet.
Very cool.
You know, he's been out of the country for coming up on a year now.
Yeah, I was gonna say, well, yeah, because we had that that barbecue at your house and right before we left, so that was very cool. So what shows do you guys have coming up here in the near future?
Coming up Friday night, we're down in Savage at Neeson Sports Bar with some really good friends, Straight Jacket, Smiling Politely, and Karma Sutra on the bill.
Oh, that's a good
one. That's going to be a really fun one. These are all bands that we know. These are all friends of ours, and we've been all wanting to do stuff together for a while. And it's probably going to be a big haze because I know Dusty from Straight Jacket's already talking about how, you know, how many shots we're lining up. So
you guys never turn down a shot, do you?
Even stuff I don't like, I won't turn down.
That's always good. So, all right, do you guys want to give this song a whirl? Again, this is the first time that I've had guests in that actually are going to play live, so we're going to give this a whirl, and hopefully if this works out, we'll do this again, and at some point, maybe we'll even have a full band in, and we'll have you guys back to do that as well. So
that puts us back in, like, the special category.
Ooh. Yeah, you guys are pretty special.
Driving that bus. The small
So, just quickly, though, you guys do have the End of Time EP out, so if you guys want to, if anybody wants to find that, you can find it at their shows. You can, I think you got, is it on iTunes as well?
iTunes, all of your digital
Spotify,
stores,
all that stuff. Make sure you go buy that. It's a really killer EP. And are you guys working on the new record now?
Yeah, we're working. We actually have the single for Brother done, and we actually debuted it last week on a local radio station. We've got like two more that are in the mixing stage, and we've probably got half the CD written. And we're hoping to have it done and out sometime July, August, sometime around there. And we're actually doing this at my place, Studio Doom. And so we're really kind of looking at kind of a really raw energy and being able to do everything ourselves, you know, and hopefully it won't suck.
Well, I have heard, well, at least I heard the initial mix of Brother, and it sounded great. So if everything else is going to come out of that studio like that, then you're good to go. It sounded really good, and you guys did a great job.
Awesome.
On the production.
Thanks.
On it. So we'll get that eventually. We'll get a copy of that, get that on the station here, so you guys can hear that mix over our airwaves. So all right, dudes, let's hear Brother.
You ready to do this?
Well, let's do it.
Yeah.
We'll set the table. Mick is nice and cleanly showered with fresh clothes on and stuff.
How do you know?
Well,
and just,
as
your
usual,
hair is all flowing, and
he doesn't have pants on. That's
sitting here in last thing. Night's clothes. My hair's a wreck.
Pants?
Drunker than hell last night.
Don't you mean leg prisons?
Leg prisons.
Have you seen my truck keys?
We'll look later. You didn't check the pizza box yet.
So. All right.
All right. Here it is. This is Matrekis.
This is Brother. Take your place. Wish I knew the way you felt, 'cause I'd rearrange your cards and pull you back from your own hell. Now only time and pain remains. I'd say that I've gone crazy, but that's just too damn insane. In my heart you'll be with me. Last time that we met, it's not as far as your last memory. When I got the call with just one pull you go, I keep telling myself it's just not real. Now your pain is gone, but mine will now live on. No one knew your end was near. I know you're here with me, in all I do and see, you're still alive inside my dreams. You're all I never have, through all the good and bad. May you forever rest in peace. That's just too damn insane. In my heart you'll be with me. The last time that we met, it's not as far as your last memories. I know you're here with me, in all I do and see, you're still alive inside my dreams. You're all I never have, all the good and bad. May you forever rest in peace.
Very nice. Very, very cool.
Thank you. Thank
exactly.
You.
Very, very cool. Very
you,
cool.
Lovelace.
I think another thing that's really making that go is nobody really expected us to do something like that.
No. If anybody is not familiar with MATREKIS, that is the complete opposite of what you guys do. You guys are an old school metal band, which is a great metal band. And yes, you're right. It's a complete opposite. But you guys did a phenomenal job at that song. That is very, very cool.
There's been a couple times that we've played, and I've kind of looked at long hair and go, I don't know if we should do this tonight.
And you know, every time we contemplate that and play it anyway,
mm-hmm.
I mean, well, you've known us for a long time, Todd.
Yep.
And we're finally leaving the regions.
Right.
You know, we've done Moline, Illinois here.
Yep, you guys are touring a little bit.
3-4 weeks ago. Every town we go to, there's at least 2-3 people that'll meet us on the street and thank us for doing something like that.
Yeah.
And when you get that kind of reception, it makes it a lot easier to do.
Oh, absolutely.
Because like, the first few times we played this song, I won't bullshit you, it was very hard to get through.
And I've seen it. I knew when you guys were at Pavs that one night, mm-hmm. I saw it. It was definitely tough. You had the hat on covering your eyes, and you know, so you couldn't see anybody in front of you.
And then, like I say, the more people that thank us, it becomes easier.
Mm-hmm.
Not that it's just, you know, just another song, but it makes it easier knowing that people out there, oh, wow, thanks.
They're connected to it. Like I said earlier, it's you know, everybody has that connection with it, you know.
Right.
With that topic. So it's been very unexpected, really, the reception of this song, and we thank everybody that says anything good about it.
Mm-hmm. Well, and you guys, you know, you finally have, you know, the combination of you two that were able to put this thing together, which may not have been good, bad, or indifferent with other people that you've had in the band, which are all good people, but at the same time, this is the combination that was able to get this thing together and put it out the way it is, which is very cool.
Chemistry really has a lot to do with, mm-hmm. with bands almost more than anything else. It's right. You know, you can put the best musicians in the entire planet together, but you know, is Yngwie and Paul McCartney really going to put out the best record ever? You know? You know, now I want to hear it now that I said it.
Yeah, me too. You think we can make that happen?
Oh, man, that's even if I had a few $1 billion, I don't know if we could swing that. Neither one of them is hurting for cash, so.
Right. So make sure you check out MATREKIS on Facebook. You know, go out there, like their page, go see them when they're in town. Again, this Friday they're out at Neeson's down in Savage with a bunch of other great bands. July they're with us, the Good Bars, at Maze Lax. Go check out their page. Make sure you follow these guys. See them on the street, kick them in the ass. They like that. So, anyways, anything else you guys want to talk about, or should we play some Kiss?
Wow, well, I like some Kiss.
You like
but
some
I'm going to tell you, I'm super excited for August.
August,
we're finally making our way to the big star state.
Yeah. Oh, that's right.
August 7th, we're doing Houston. August 8th, we're in Dallas-Fort Worth at the Rail Club. And the Rail Club, for me, is pretty much a bucket club, because that's just so many iconic bands have been there.
Right.
We're starting to, you know, we've got offers from almost everywhere in the country to go. It just makes, you know, we just got to figure out what makes sense for us to go and do. But yeah, the Texas, that's going to be great. We've done a couple smaller little jaunts in the last few weeks, kind of getting into it, and you know, this one's going to be really, really cool. Plus, there might be a couple other gigs in between there as we go and come back from there as well.
Yeah,
and
some fill-in stuff on the way down and back.
Yeah, we're talking like Kansas City, mm-hmm. and mm-hmm. I think Austin is kind of on the records as well. But yeah, it'd be cool. I used to live in Texas, so I'm excited to go back there and check it out.
That'd be very cool. And just to mention, you do have two other guys, Ty Hall and Corey Kirk, are the drummer and bass player of your band.
Just the bass
player. Ty is just the bass player. I mean,
don't ask him nothing. He's just the bass player.
He's more than happy to tell you.
That's right.
I'm just a bass player, dude.
Yeah, you know what? And they're really good guys, too.
They are.
Ty really, when it comes to the sound, is, you know, he wrote most of everything prior to me joining the band, so that's really the sound is what he has done. And he's such a character, and he's such a great guy to work with. And Corey just came in to the fold with us. God, was it October when he joined?
Wasn't very long ago, a few months. Yeah.
And he's such a good guy. He all he wants to do is make the absolute best effort that he can in the band, and he's so easy to get along with. And also makes his own barbecue sauce.
Hey.
Uh-huh.
We'll be having some of that tonight.
Sweet habanero. Yeah.
Oh, is that what it is, a habanero?
Uh-huh. Ooh,
I'm glad we're at my house, so yeah. I don't leave. But yeah, they're, you know, and we're all, you know, one of the biggest things about us now is how well we all get along. So it makes everything a lot easier. I mean, everybody that's ever been in a band knows what it's like to be with somebody that is difficult, you know? And I know you're laughing, because I know me and you were talking with the same person, but... But yeah, I mean, that's just the way it is. I mean, it's chemistry,
right.
And, you know, it's just a cool thing to be able to play with these guys, and we actually hang out and like each other. Well...
Tolerate each other.
Tolerate. Let's just say we haven't gotten into fights.
Yeah, there you go. Well, you guys are doing great. Congratulations. It is well deserved for you guys. You're your music is doing well. You're getting on the road. It's very cool to see, and it's all from hard work, because you guys have worked very, very hard, especially you, Long Hair. You've been pushing this thing for a long time, and it's finally paying off for you.
That's so me. He's talking about me right now. It's all about me.
It's all about you, Mr. Lead Singer, you know.
Mr. Lead Singer, who I forgot my keys.
No, I didn't forget them. I can't find them.
Can't find them.
Crazy night before, you know, all that stuff. So
the weekend's not done yet either.
Oh, no. Just starting.
Very cool.
Well, Jambo, thanks for having us.
Absolutely.
You've been probably one of the biggest supporters ever since this rock show started.
And we don't even have to pay you that much.
No, you don't. It's pretty cool. No, from the minute I saw you guys at the 400 Bar, we've been friends since. And I love your band, and you know that, and we are good friends. And so, you know, there's always something to that. But yeah, I mean, I saw you before I knew you that night, and I've been a fan ever since. So anything I can do, you know that I'm willing to support you guys, and we'll do this thing together. So
anything.
Well, almost anything.
Oh, dang it.
Pants must be worn.
Leg prisons.
Look at the time. I gotta get going.
Anyways, again, thank you guys for coming in. Anytime you are welcome to come on down, hang out, bring a record, and we'll play some stuff and talk smart, as my dad always used to say. So
right on. Yeah.
So here we go. Thanks, brother.
Thanks for having us.
Side two. Thank you, MATREKIS. And side two of KISS Creatures of the Night. You're listening to the Saturday Morning Coffee Jams on SignetRadio.com.
Oh, she's a killer. Bitches insane, she deals in pain. She's a killer.
Yeah.
You've been listening to the Saturday Morning Coffee Jams on CyanetRadio.com. Thanks for tuning in. Thanks to my pals in MATREKIS for hanging out with me today. And real quick, on the 3rd of May, make sure you get down to Neeson's for the Chris Kirker benefit. He's suffering from stage 4 kidney cancer, and we can use all the help we can get. There's 10 bands, including Hairball, my band The Good Bars, and a bunch of other bands as well. So get down to there. Check out Chris Kirker benefit on Facebook, and give us a try. This is, you've been listening to the Saturday Morning Coffee Jams on CyanetRadio.com.